कांग्रेस नेता राहुल गांधी మాట్లాడుతున్నారు లైవ్ చూద్దాం
क्वेश्चन से हमें आगे बढ़ना है और निकलना है एक प्रकार से। लॉकडाउन हुआ नहीं हुआ वो सब ठीक है, उसकी जगह है, वो हो गया है, वो पास्ट में है, मगर अब खोलने की स्ट्रेटेजी की जरूरत है। दो तीन इस पे मैं आपको न्यूआंस बता देता हूं। आप किसी भी बिजनेस वाले से पूछें तो वो आपको बताएंगे कि जो हमारी सप्लाई चेन है वो रेड येलो एंड ग्रीन, रेड ऑरेंज एंड ग्रीन सिस्टम के बीच में से निकलती है। तो रेड ऑरेंज एंड ग्रीन का जो हेल्थ केयर वाला सिस्टम है और इकोनॉमिक जो सप्लाई चेन है उसमें क्लैश है। तो उनका कहना है कि ये दोनों चीजों को रिजॉल्व करने की जरूरत है। हमने पहले भी कहा कि पैसे की जरूरत आज है, माइग्रेंट्स को पैसा आज देना है, सपोर्ट आज देना है, गरीब लोगों को आज पैसा देना है और जो स्मॉल एंड मीडियम इंडस्ट्रीज हैं उनको आज मदद करनी है, कल नहीं परसों नहीं, आज। क्योंकि अगर हमने आज नहीं मदद की तो जो जॉब लॉसेस हो रही हैं वो सुनामी बन जाएंगी। तो उसको हमें उनको कॉन्फिडेंस देना है, उनको प्रोटेक्शन प्रोटेक्ट करना है। तो पहले सवाल का जवाब यह है कि एक स्ट्रेटजी निकालनी है, तरीका निकालना है, रास्ता निकालना है और उसमें कांग्रेस पार्टी मदद करने के लिए तैयार है। क्योंकि हमारे भी स्टेट्स हैं, हमारे पास भी काफी लोग हैं जो इन चीजों को समझते हैं, इकोनॉमिक्स को समझते हैं और स्पिरिट यही है प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस का। आपका दूसरा सवाल, ये जो मेरे कॉन्वर्सेशंस हैं, देखिए नॉर्मली मैं काफी लोगों से बातचीत करता हूं नॉर्मल कोर्स में और उनमें से काफी लोगों के जो कॉन्वर्सेशंस होते हैं काफी इंटरेस्टिंग होते हैं। तो मैंने सोचा कि एक झलक मैं उन कॉन्वर्सेशंस को हिंदुस्तान की जनता को, लोगों को, बाकी लोगों को भी दिखा दूं। वही बेसिक आइडिया था कि जो एक्सपर्ट से बातचीत हो रही है, जो मुझे सीखने को मिल रहा है, समझने को मिल रहा है, मैं थोड़ा सा वो दूसरे लोगों को भी दिखा दूं। बाकी उसके पीछे कोई स्ट्रेटजी नहीं है।
थैंक यू सर। मे आई आस्क राजदीप जी टू कम इन सिंस यू हैड अ रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन।
Mr. Gandhi, first of all, we all appreciate you doing these conversations because they help in building an engagement with the press community. So thank you very much and stay well. My question is linked to what happened this morning in Aurangabad. Early this morning, as you know, 15 workers were crushed to death in a train incident. This is, part of an ongoing tragedy, unfolding tragedy of migrant labor, Mr. Gandhi. In Karnataka yesterday, the government did a U-turn. First said no trains will be allowed, eventually allowed trains even as the workers were walking. Even as we speak, several workers are still walking hundreds of kilometers home. Do you think the time has come for a national migrant labor policy? And does that involve cash transfers that you are talking about right away or something more long term? Because the Odisha High Court today, for example, has said they will not allow migrant workers to come into Odisha unless they are shown to be COVID negative. Do you believe it? This has to go beyond COVID? And in the immediate, would you want trains across the country as the first step and then a national long-term migrant labor policy? And what would that involve, Mr. Gandhi?
Look, there are pushes and pulls with regards to the migrant labor. First broad thing that we are saying is take the idea of Nyay and start putting money directly into 50% of India's poor households. Just without thinking of it, just start doing that. It's not going to cost so much. 65,000 crores is what it's going to cost. And it will completely transform the way people are thinking about this current situation, their current situation. Because we have to understand, if you are on daily wages, you do not have choices. You simply do not have a choice. So we have to give them a choice. That's point number one. Point number two is, the transfer of migrants. I am not an expert on this. So I'm not going to sit and opine what I think about trains. But what I do think is that a conversation between states has to happen. And these decisions have to be made with empathy towards migrants, with thinking about their rights, so not crushing their rights, but they have to happen between states and the center has to oversee them. The pain has to be reduced, absolutely.
So you're saying the minimum income right away, Mr. Gandhi? Am I correct? Yeah.
I'm saying that we are in an emergency. We require absolutely the idea of NAIC, call it whatever you want, call it something else. Call it Pradhan Mantri Yojana, whatever you want to do. But the idea of injecting immediately 7,500 rupees directly into 50% of Indian households is critical, and it's not such a big ask price. Second, the idea that we can simply let our job creators drown, this is not feasible. We have to protect them. We have to make sure that we give them a wage protection scheme, 1 lakh crore wage protection scheme, and 1 lakh crore credit guarantee scheme to MSMEs. And then we have to give them 6 month interest subsidy. So we have to build a wall for them so that they can fight what is coming. We have to give them build a financial support behind them. Look, it is pretty clear that a lot of these companies are going to go down. If we do not do anything, massive number of them are going to go down. So we have to ensure that we build a wall and we protect as many of them as possible. Now, there's another thing here, which is something important, that when we think about India's business system, we cannot simply say MSMEs and not big business, because there is a link between big business and MSMEs. Most of the stuff the MSMEs supply goes to big business. So if your big business isn't firing, your MSMEs can't fire. So there has to be a view where we are thinking systemically, where we are working to start the economy, where we are certainly giving much more benefit to the small and medium industry, but we're also keeping in mind that there is a link between large business and small and medium business. And if we suddenly say, okay, only small business is going to be helped and big business is going to be left to its own devices, we'll actually harm small business as well. Thing to understand in this current situation is everything is connected. And if you want to start the engine, you cannot think of starting just one part of the engine. You've got to start the whole engine. That is why creating demand, putting money into the system, putting money into poor people's hands, helping small and medium businesses, making sure you're protecting some of the larger players. These are all things that are interlinked if you want to start the economy.
Thank you, sir. May I go?